My name is Father Chris Torek. I came from the United States, South America, to sing here today for you. We are in a beautiful church. Jesus Christ is here. So we came to pray. But pray very joyfully. Not pray like, no. Pray joyfully. Hallelujah! Right? So let's begin with prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, we ask you to be here with us. To give us grace so our tongues can give those who came here joy and happiness to be with Jesus Christ in this church tonight. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Are you ready to sing with us? Thank you. We'll begin about inviting Jesus Christ to come. Come, Lord Jesus. Thank you. I was born in Silesia. So Silesia is a lot of places where people play blues. Blues music is about God who's going to rescue people who are very much tormented by other people. And they developed that blues on three chords, sometimes among slavery in the United States, because they were very, very sad that other people are making them slaves. So they asked God, they said, God, help us. Be with us. And they play this music. So I'll play the music for you that is about the need of feeling God close to me. Here we go. It's blues.
Good guitar.
So I said, wow, I cannot take the guitar anywhere with me because the So I bought a different guitar, which is exactly similar to that. It's an exact copy of this. And I asked God to give me that another guitar to create some new songs. And as soon as I opened it from California, it came from California, I opened this guitar, I sit, and I try to be like, what can I write about? About God? About peace? And about music? And I started to sing.
Thank you.
stand behind me. It's a wonderful choir, right? Wonderful. I can tell you that in the United States, I'm singing every Sunday during the 5 p.m. Mass to bring people closer to church. I play different rhythm blues, I rap, I play rock. I do everything that I can, that God gave me the gift for, to bring others to the church. Some priests are very good at architecture. They build churches. Some priests are very good at making their own garden very beautiful. Some priests are good preachers. They speak from the heart. I can sing to people. So I'm singing, and God gave me a gift of singing. I believe that because it came from my father, who made me to play accordion when I was 6 years old. That's one thing. But I gained that free. I didn't pay for it. It just happens in my life. I don't get to different people and say, here is $200, can you write me a song so I can sing? No, it just I pray to God, and a song happens. And I am so amazed. And that's what happens. And I feel so humble. And that's what happens. I didn't go to different schools to learn. I just receive that. So how can I charge it? I'm giving it free, and I am thankful to everybody who wants to do it with me. So when we pray twice. And we sing, we pray three times, right? Because we sing. So I wrote the song about it. It's called, When I Pray and Feel God All Around, I Wonder If I Pray Twice. Keep that in the notes like that. When I pray and feel God all around, then I sing. I wonder if I pray. who he really impressed me with his sense of music, sense of arrangements, sense of so many ways of expressing the joy also of being Christian, of being close to Jesus Christ. And I went back to the United States and I said, hey, you people are sitting in a church like, oh yeah, we are in a church. And here in the Germany, there is a choir of people who not everybody speaks English, but they sing joyfully. They praise God with their voices, and they want to do it. So when there was an idea in Pope in Rio de Janeiro announced that the next World Youth Day will be in Krakow, Poland, something happened to my mind. I said, wow, I can put my friends who are in the United States, teach them all the songs. I can come here to Germany, work with Anton on arrangements and the choir he's doing for so many years, harmonies. He's doing wonderful, the best thing I know ever who does harmonies. Really soft, very coming to your heart. And then I have this wonderful group of singers. So I asked them, who wants to sing in my band? It's called International Rock Gospel Group. And some of them said, I will. And we created a new choir, which I went to Poland, and I asked Polish singers, I said, hey, do you want to join the International Rock Gospel Group? There'll be Americans, Germans, and Polish people. And we'll sing together. They said, sure, you come to Poland anyway, right? So it's close. So that's how we create out of choirs that they belong to. Anton has 5 choirs, so he's working with about 200, 300 people. And he asked all them, do you want to be international gospel group? And they all came. And now I'm thankful to them that they came here today to sing with me for you tonight. So I want to thank Anton, the choir, Martin, and all those who are here with your applause. Thank you. It's a very unique situation because it's international. So we practice, and I tell them by Skype. We didn't really do it yet so far, but I want to practice with them by Skype. You will turn the Skype, I'll turn the Skype, and we can practice by Skype. By next year, the technology will be so different that you can have more possibilities to practice. And then I hope to play next year for World Youth Day, for Pope Francis, who will come to Krakow, and 2 million other people who will come, young people, they will come. And I really ask you to pray for it. We applied for it, I didn't get a yes. Everybody says, oh, you definitely will play. But I didn't get the official yes. So I ask you to pray for it, and we can go. And then we come again next year as a big choir, and we'll sing again for you. And we'll say, hey, we sang for the Pope. Ooh. But you already know us, so we'll say, hey, yeah, we know how to sing. So recently in the summer, I want to create some happy songs, especially for the sons. So I did, and I said, one Sunday, there was a song, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this is really sad. So I said, let's do it that. Taste and see. Let's sing together. You clap and we'll sing. Here we go. So that's how the masses look in my church. Everybody's clapping, they say, "Dash," and see, that's what they do. And priests who come from outside, it's like, "What is this, Father? What are you doing? Baptist church here?" And I'm saying, "No, we just enjoy to be with Jesus Christ." And that's the most important, right? So, here we go. The next song that I just wrote, which is from summer, is "The Lord Upholds My Life." It's from So I thought I'll do something very similar to Responsorial Psalm. And this Responsorial Psalm sounded with the arrangements for the rap music very familiar to them. And they were coming to the church saying, hey, the priest is cool. And the father and your parents said, I think the bass is too high, the bass is... And they said, father, you don't know that. It's cool. So then I noticed the difference. For the parents, it was too much bass. For the children, it was just right. And then I realized we have to speak to the young people. Even if it's too much bass for us. Even if the music is not relating to us, because how can it? But we need to. They have different way of living. They approach life different. You know, they're always on phones, right? They're always texting. Hello, how are you? I'm fine. They're always texting, right? Whenever you talk to them, how are you? They don't talk anymore. They say, oh, he's my friend. Hello, my friend. I see you in the line in the shop. Right? How are you doing? Fine. Hey, how are you doing? Okay, I'm doing fine. I'm like, wow. So, but we have to. There is a phenomenon of form, and it will pass by, but that's the way we know. Imagine yourself, what did you do when you were a young person? When they developed, you know, the boombox, two speakers boombox, people walking with the boombox on the street, right? And saying, hey, I have the music right here in my ear. They were walking. When they were adapters, they played the music before they had the records. You know, you remember the records, right? The 45 or the 33. And they put the record. Music is gone. Now they have CDs. They have iTunes. They have everything. So we have to adjust to them. We have to find them where they are and minister to them where they are. When people go to different continents, it's not good to tell them we are better than you, but to minister to them where they are. I saw the movie Mission in '80s, and the main character went to the jungle of South America and started to play flute.
Let us see your face and
can express ourselves. We can say, well, drop your boombox. Let's listen what we do in the church. That's how we pray God, how we praise Him and invite Him. Because it is good to give thanks to God. So for this next song, I was talking to my friend and I said, you know, I want to write a song about prayer. But not prayer, that prayer, you know, that every song is written, but specifically about prayer before the meal. How many of you pray before the meal? Thank you. One person. Okay. Thank you so much, because that's important. You know, people forget to pray before they eat. They come in and their prayer looks like that. Hey, it looks delicious. Let's eat it, you know, quickly. And then they start to eat. But to thank God for even food that is on our table is such a common thing to do. To thank God would be who we are, how do we approach each day. To be courageous, to thank God for that. It's not because our grandma told us to do, but because it's just the right thing to do. When you teach your children how to thank God for food, then maybe one day they will thank you for something. Because they, nowadays, that's what they told me, I don't have children, but they said, and they take everything for granted. What is my credit card? What is my Xbox? What is my PlayStation? I need sneakers, I need this, I need that. And the parents, thinking that they're making them happy, they give them everything. Or they stop, and they make them unhappy, and they hate them. The best thing is to say, hey, let's work together. Let's thank God for the gift that we receive. I'll work for it, you pray for it, and we'll go and see what can be back to you. And then when you get it, you say, let's pray now, thanking God that I was able to walk and have enough money to give it to you. The kids were like, wow. Well, that's true. Because without God, I'll be able to do it. I believe. When you teach them that there is a relationship between God and your heart, they might enter that relationship. And it will benefit you. Because one day they will come to you and say, you know what, Mom, Dad, thank you. I think I want to thank God for you, for what you did to me. Wow, wouldn't it be good? So here is the song. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. Lord, it is good to give thanks. Make it happen.
Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
It is good to give thanks, right? Because people need to remember the very simple word, thank you. It's a very heart-opening word. And who's going to bring that word back into the world if not you who came here to this council? You can go back to your home and say, you know, Father Chris, priest from America, he came and he told us to say, thank you. And they said, really? Yeah. And then start to say thank you. And say, can you give me that remote control for TV? Ah, here you go. Thank you. What's wrong with you? Nothing. I just want to say thank you. Okay. After 2 weeks, they'll start to make fun maybe of it. And they'll learn to say thank you. They come to the table and they said, so do you like the soup? Yeah. You're welcome. Okay, thank you. Right? And that's how you teach them. And after a while, they will come and they will say, here we go. Okay, yeah, thank you. And they will expect from you to say thank you. And look how many of us is here. If we teach that to 5 people, next year, there will be a lot of people saying to each other in Sigmaringen, hey, thank you, Dr. Shane, yeah, Dr. Shane. Everybody said, what's wrong with this town? Oh, they are just kind. So, when there is something wrong somewhere, and you say, oh yeah, I turned the TV and oh yeah, don't complain. Start to work with your own heart, with your own family, within you, and then spread the goodness. And if it's good, and you ask God to help you, and God is good and He's ready to help us, that's what He does. He creates good.
To someone that loves them back. God loves you.
Wow. And overboard. All right, here we go. Clap twice with us. Tell the sound that God knows it back. Clap twice with us. Turn around, tell to your neighbor that you love them too. Turn to each other and say, I love you too. Okay? Let's sing it and see how we will do. Here we go. Clap twice.
It's everything, alright.
Oh, yeah.
It's everything.
they said, you know, they come from all these countries and they come and pray. And they all got, yeah, please sit, because some people sit, some people not go there. So they come from all over the world and they say, we want to be together with the rest of the world. We want to pray. And that's wonderful. Wonderful moment. And what they do, they are Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and next year is going to be in July, between 21st of July to like 31st of July. And they come and they pray together with different groups. They sometimes mingle with different nationalities. I remember last time I wasn't in Rio de Janeiro, but I was in Sydney, Australia, and we met with different kind of people from who knows where, and they were saying, hey, Jesus Christ, and they were all singing and praying. And you come back from this event such a different person. It's like you plugging yourself into the charger, high-speed charger. You come back and you say, wow, I live with the world that believes in God and is so happy. And I want to bring that world to my family. And then you really say, hey, it's really possible to change this town, to change the family, to change youth group, to change the parish, to change everything into this wonderful, wonderful, prayerful group of joyful and happy people believing in God. I think the world problem is that so many years people try to make their world cutless without God. Ubezpośrednie świata, I call it, without God. And now the effects of this are, and everybody's surprised, oh, look what happened. Well, you know, if you unplug your vacuum cleaner while you're vacuuming, then you say like, what happened? Well, you unplug yourself from a source of power. You can still vacuum forever. But when you plug yourself to power, it goes and it actually works what it's supposed to. So, if you support us with this, we thank you so much by your prayers, but whatever you can help us with. I hope that the whole choir is here today, they will be able to go. I'm not making a promise. Are you promised to go next year with me? You have to tell them, are they going next year with me? Yeah. They are all like, wait a minute, what is real? Step by step, they will go. And then they'll come back and you can see them in the town, in Zimmeringen or whatever. And you can say, why are you so happy? I've been to Portugal today. Really? Yeah. How was it? It was great. I was in a concert in San Fidelis Church. Really? That's how, if you can go there from this parish with us, you don't have to sing, but you can sign with the parishes, with the dioceses, and just go there and experience. That's really wonderful. To get out of your own shell and to see what other people do and how they live, and then come back and break the shell and live fully. It's worth it. If it's for good, if it's for God. So that's how it is, and we made a song to go out to all the world and tell the good news. So we are telling the good news to you, you will tell the good news to your families, and it goes like that. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. I had the opportunity to sing that song everywhere. Like 2 years ago, I went to Krakow and the priest is asking me, okay, you coming? I said, yes. What are you going to sing? And I said, well, and the full church said, come, a priest from the United States, come here and sing the song. I came like, okay, go out to all the world, tell the good news. And the people like it. So what did I do? I asked him a letter about Monday. Today is what, Friday? I sent him a letter on Monday and I said, "Dear Holy Father, I wrote a song about all, but your introduction is such an intrinsic element of that song. Would you please give me permission?" So when he sends the letter back, it will be like, yes. Because we have permission from the Pope to use that sentence that he said, that encouragement that he said to everybody. So this is how the song goes. Do you want to hear it? Can you stand and do like that?
Hallelujah.
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 go, right?